Well, what we intended to do in this particular debate was to look also at how investor sentiment is being heard. Is this a case of overreach by the CBI? But there are serious questions if one looks at the FIR, of which we now have a copy, on just who the finger is being pointed at this stage. Joining us to debate all of these points, Randeep Singh Surjewala, Cabinet Minister in the Haryana government, spokesperson of the Congress Party, Captain Abhimanyu with me in the studio, spokesperson of the BJP, Jay Panda, Lok Sabha MP of the BJD, the former CBI Director, Mr. R.K. Raghavan, also with us, and Meera Sanyal, Country Executive and Chairperson of the Royal Bank of Scotland. Thank you all very much for being with us. Randeep, one of the points that this FIR says, and it refers on two occasions to the use of the terms competent authority. In the first instance, it says this competent authority rejected Hindalco's bid to get control of this coal block. Later on, it says that this competent authority said, okay, fine, and the Hindalco process was thereby started. The big question, and it says, in the first instance, along with certain proposals for amendment of guidelines, they were placed before the competent authority who approved the proposed changes. It says who approved the proposed changes. Who is this competent authority?
So, this is a Supreme Court monitor investigation. An FIR has been registered and appropriate truth and facts will be placed in public domain sooner than later, I am certain. Number two, I also want to say, I heard Mr. Parekh on your channel as also on other channels yesterday. Specific assertions and questions were put to him, whether the Prime Minister, as you are trying to hint, influenced him in any manner in allocating a coal block in favor of Hindalco, and the answer that he categorically gave was no. He was also asked whether anybody in Prime Minister's office, and Mr. Nair and Mr. Chatterjee was named by the correspondent or any other official, influenced him or suggested that Hindalco should be given this block. And the answer that he gave was no. He was also asked whether or not the Prime Minister in any way influenced his recommendation of letting the block, coal block,
no,
be
but
shared.
Randeep, these are two
Hindalco
separate issues.
Randeep,
these are two issues, because I asked that question and you were on the program yesterday.
Why are we hinting?
And so let me tell you what I asked him.
So
no, I'm not hinting. This is the CBI which is pointing fingers, Randeep. You're raising a separate point, and the point that you're raising, and this is a question I asked Parekh last night, I asked the former coal secretary, is there anything to suggest that the decision taken by the Prime Minister was wrong? Is there anything to suggest that the decision that he had taken was wrong? And he says, no, the decision was not wrong. But in the FIR today, this story has moved on because there are new details. It refers to a competent authority signing off on the decisions taken by the coal secretary. And it also refers to Kumar Mangalam Birla. So Parekh's original point remains valid. Why has Birla been named? Why has he been named? Why is this competent authority not named?
So this is for the Central Bureau of Investigation to answer. I'm sorry, I do not represent the CBI here.
I agree with you.
I represent the Indian National Congress here. And it's a question that you should put to CBI.
Absolutely.
As to why have they registered the FIR?
Why
have they looked at the facts?
Absolutely.
Have they gone into
Randeep,
the facts?
You hit
have
the
they,
nail on
have
the head.
They examined
why
the
hasn't
file?
The CBI
have
named the competent
to a
authority? That's the question, Randeep. It's the absolute, it's the perfect question. It summarizes this entire story. Why has, if there are names in this FIR?
It's a Supreme Court.
There are names over here.
So this is a Supreme Court monitored investigation.
It names Mr. Parekh. It names one of the foremost industrialists
in the
country.
Please have the patience to listen.
But I'll come back to you. I'm sorry I'm interrupting
Absolutely.
You. I know. Just give me 1 second and then you and I will come back to you. It doesn't name the Prime Minister.
Okay.
Why doesn't it name the Prime Minister? Go ahead. Randeep.
Your answer, question is to me. It doesn't name the Prime Minister because Central Bureau of Investigation feels that way in this particular case. It's a Supreme Court monitored investigation. Yes. Government is not interfering in the process at all. I'm sure if Mr. Birla has nothing to do with it, which prima facie it appears to be to me as a layman, or Mr. Parekh has no role to play as Mr. Parekh suggests and he has acted bona fide, the truth will come out. Why are we jumping the gun? Why are we prejudging the case? And why are some political parties trying to muddy political atmosphere in this country?
You're muddying the political atmosphere, Captain Abhimanyu.
I'm sorry. On one hand, Mr. Randeep Surjewala accepts that, yes, there is a possible anomaly in the FIR filed by the CBI. Prime Minister should have been there in the FIR because he was the cabinet minister, and under his signature, the coal block was allotted. And which is actually the whole point of issue here. Secondly, Mr. Randeep Surjewala constantly maintains that BJP is trying to muddy the political waters. It is the UPA, it is the Congress party which has actually vitiated the entire environment, the business climate in this country by the crony capitalism which this country has seen in last 9.5 years. And on the top of all this massive corruption that they've indulged in, they indulged in a mammoth cover-up operation which will go down in the history of India, that how the corruption was actually tried, the attempt of cover-up was made. I'm sorry, Mr.
Are you saying that the CBI is covering up?
CBI is covering up, and
despite what the Supreme Court is saying, the CBI continues to cover up.
I don't understand the provisions and the procedures by which the CBI could differentiate between a coal secretary and the coal cabinet minister, under whose signature the coal block was allotted.
Let me put that question to R.K. Raghavan, former CBI director. Sir, it's got two names here. There's a third name missing over here. Does this seem that somebody is trying to protect the Prime Minister? In this case, the CBI, this is a CBI FIR.
Okay. Thank you very much for inviting me to this evening's discussion. Yes, you are right. There are only two names I mentioned, and the FIR doesn't refer to the Prime Minister. You must remember that this is an FIR drawn up after a preliminary inquiry. So to fault the CBI for filing an FIR is absolutely wrong. You must remember, under a preliminary inquiry, which the CBI did, it does not have the authority to conduct searches or summon witnesses. And if a witness is summoned during a preliminary inquiry, you could jolly well say that he was not required to be present at the preliminary inquiry.